and may have a rash or may have swelling of their body.
A serious inflammatory condition found in kids around the world, health experts say it could stem from COVID-19. Working for you, RTV6's Megan Sangtorum spoke to a doctor from Riley Hospital for Children, as well as a daycare, what you need to know to keep your child safe.
Healthcare experts say it's rare, but a potentially dangerous condition is affecting some children, one that can cause inflammation of the heart or other organs.
With the specific features, fever and rashes, red eyes, swelling.
John Christensen is the medical director of infection prevention at Riley Hospital for Children. He says so far, they have not seen any cases of this here locally, but it's something they are keeping an eye out for. Local daycare centers are doing the same.
You know, we're doing all of the things that have been recommended and trying to go above and beyond.
Here at Early Learning Indiana, they've implemented social distancing practices, additional cleaning routines, and they're conducting health screenings at the door. Leaders say they know conditions can quickly change, though.
That will be the key piece, is making sure that we're monitoring children throughout the day and making sure that we stay aware of anything that changes and then letting families know.
According to the CDC, this inflammatory syndrome has been reported in the UK and New York City. Many children experiencing it have also tested positive for COVID-19. Doctors say they're prepared to treat potential cases because this syndrome resembles something called Kawasaki disease, which is often triggered by infections.
Which is an illness that in most children's hospitals in the United States and around the world, we have a lot of experience with Kawasaki because we see a lot of Kawasaki children.
He says most children testing positive for COVID-19 here locally show mild respiratory symptoms and make a full recovery.
The important thing is to remind people that that infections with COVID in children are generally mild.
Working for you, Megan Sangtorum, RTV6.
And the CDC is asking physicians to report any suspected cases of this inflammatory syndrome so they can continue to track and monitor it.